Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So welcome to the Fast Track series for NABARD Grade 2018 brought to you by EduTap. Now this is a regular series where each day we come up with a lecture which is very short, but it contains very important concepts and data points for the examination. So friends, kindly revise the series multiple number of times before you go to the examination hall, because there are numerous data points involved and these are very, very important for your examination. Now this lecture is lecture number 26. Okay friends, before we begin, let me just tell you that the important data points that we have picked up is from an agriculture book which is written by Nimrat Sunda. So we have picked up on those data points that we think are very relevant and important for our examination. So friends, by now there are so many things that you need to remember, so it really becomes harder for us. So what you need to do is make sure that you revise them ample number of times and you study them with some amount of, you know, techniques, or maybe just club them together on one side so that, you know, it becomes easy for you. So first we shall see the composition of milk by percentage weight of different species. So there was a question from this in our examination, prelim examination. So let us just anyway have a look at it. So there might be a possibility of it coming in the mains as well, but we're not sure of it because we have already got a question from this area. But still, let us just not miss it. So there are various species like cow, buffalo, goat, sheep, camel and human. So you need to know the water percentage, the fat, the protein and the lactose. So what you need to do with this data is kindly make sure which has the greatest percentage or the lowest one. That is going to help you out. So it is not possible or it is not required for you to learn each and every percentage. That is not going to help you at all. For example, when you talk about fat, you need to remember that buffalo's milk has the greatest percentage of fat when compared to the other species. So this is one important data point that you need to remember, right? So like when you talk about protein, it is obviously going to be sheep. Right, when you talk about lactose, then you can see that human has the greatest percentage. So these are some of the smaller things that you need to you know, make sure that you have a rough idea regarding this. Okay, so make sure the least and the greatest, and you need to know the comparison as well. Now we are going to have a look at the classification of the cattle breeds in India. So first we shall talk about the dairy breed. So we shall see the important ones, the names, native and the features, right? So what you need to do is just keep in mind the names as well as some of the important features, okay? Like for example, you need to know that Sahiwal, Gir and Sindhi or Red Sindhi, these are dairy breeds. Okay, in this time prelims also there was a question regarding this, so then you need to know the native of it. Okay, and if you talk about Sahiwal, for example, you need to know that it is a native of Pakistan. Okay, and there's one important point that it is the highest and sweetest milk producing cow breed in India. Okay, so this is something which you need to remember. Okay, let's move on. Next, we have come to the draught breeds. So there's Malvi, Nagori and Amrit Mahal, right? And you can see the native states and some of the important features. So this you need to remember by yourself. We can just give you directions as to what things are relevant and important, right? These things you need to sit down, pause the video, make sure that you memorize them, because there's no point in explaining these things. Just we'll give you an orientation that yes, these are important points. Then comes the dual purpose breeds, right? There are six names that are given here. That's Haryana, Kankraj, Rathi, Tharpakar, Ongol and Mewati. Okay, so kindly make sure that you remember these names. It's very important, very easy as well. Okay, and just see if there are any relevant points that you need to stick to. Okay. Then there's a list of sheep breeds out here. So we have classified them based on the regions. So you can see it is Himalayan, Western, Southern and Eastern. There's a very neat list which is presented. So you can see the breed names given. So you need to make sure that you remember these. There's no other go. You need to take some time, maybe spend some 10 to 15 minutes on it and revise it at least two times. So after a point of time, you will be able to recognize the answer when you see the options in the paper. Okay, so that is what we need. There it is not going to be fill-ups or something like that. So you can keep yourselves relaxed, because I'm sure that once or twice, if you are putting in your full concentration and having a look at this list, if you see the correct answer in the options, you'll be able to spot it very accurately. Okay, so for example, let us see, if you're talking about Himalayan, then the breed names would be Gaddi, Rampur, Bushier and Bakarwal. Okay, so obviously they are native to Jammu and Kashmir. Then remarks, you can just see if there is anything which is very important, like for example, Lohi is obtained from Bakarwal. Okay, so you can just have this an idea. Okay, now if you talk about Southern, that's Deccani, Nellore, Mandya. Okay, and I think this can be an important point, that when you could talk about the breed name, that's Deccani, it's good for mutton, it could fit for weaving kambal also. So this is, yes, this is a very trivial point, but you can just have a look at it. Okay, so now even I have mentioned it, so sometimes if this comes in the examination, you will retrieve from your memory and you'll be able to mark it. Okay, then you talk about Eastern, there is this Hisar Dale breed. Okay, it is developed at Hisar, and you can see that it's a cross of Bikaneri and Merino. Okay, so this is something important. Yes, so you can just have a look at it, retain this fact. So friends, with this we have come to the end of this lecture today. So as the days are nearing for the examination, we are keeping the lectures very short, nearly 5 to 6 minutes only, so that you find enough time to retain these facts, because it's not good to overburden yourself every day, because already we are under pressure, because we would have been revising so many things, there are so many things which are left out, we will be finishing that. So instead of overburdening ourselves, we'll keep the information very limited, but still your job is to make sure that you finish the information or retain or memorize the information that we provide as part of each lecture. So that is the entire motive behind coming up with these short lectures. Till then friends, thank you so much and happy learning.